She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead.
Welcome back into the nest for more intimate chats with the lovebirds. Now, with more discussion about love, sex, and relationships, here are Drs. Chuck and JoAnn Bird.
Welcome back. Sorry about that premature commercial that we went to last segment. I guess they thought that was funny. Anyway, we're back talking about rapid and premature ejaculation, which is really, we're making light here. We're using humor as a way to kind of deal with this very serious topic, but it is a serious topic. And like I said, 30% of men have suffered or suffer with premature ejaculation. So it's one of the most common sexual dysfunctions out there.
Definitely.
And boy, does it create such distress, anxiety, depression.
It does.
An avoidance of sex. Because can you imagine if you felt like, especially after the first time, my gosh, I didn't last as long as what I wanted to, or I saw that my partner was disappointed in that.
Right, or not satisfied.
Boy, you're definitely not going to be looking forward to it.
It starts almost that snowball effect.
Absolutely.
Because then you start worrying about it, and then
creates
you don't
want to do it. Creates that
performance anxiety. And that's where the erectile dysfunction can come into
exactly.
play as well.
Exactly. So this is a very serious thing. And what we were saying before, we were talking about some of the biological or, you know, medical causes that could be there for PE, which
right.
again, like we were saying before, diabetes, endocrine issues,
prostate infection,
abnormal hormone levels, thyroid problems. There can be all kinds of things. So definitely go to your doctor, get a good medical rule out to make sure that there is nothing causing it, even medications.
That's true. That's true.
And you have to, of course, if you're using drugs or alcohol, that's going to impact it as well.
Right.
So there you go. Now, there are some other things that could be causing it as well. If it's once a medical, you know,
rule out has been there.
Exactly. Once that's been done.
Right.
Then, like I said, there could be other sexual dysfunctions that could be there, like ED that's causing it. Could be stress. That
Big
could be causing
stress.
It, the performance anxiety,
yep.
could even be relationship issues. For example, somebody could be fine and never have experienced rapid ejaculation before, but
sure.
all of a sudden now they're in a relationship and they're experiencing what we call more acquired rapid ejaculation. It's acquired, meaning it's not been something there lifelong.
Right, which there is that as well. There's lifelong premature
exactly.
ejaculation as well.
And so you need to come in and talk to a sex therapist because there are things that can be done to help this. That's
right,
sure.
And I was going to say, I don't know if people have been actually listening to the bumper music.
Yes.
But it's not just as easy as like some of the songs say, you know,
yes.
like the,
just relax.
I think it was the relax, don't do it, you know,
yeah.
or slow ride, take it easy. It's not about just breathe and you'll be
take
fine.
Take it easy. No.
There's techniques that we're going to talk to you about tonight that
exactly.
are, you know, can help you.
Exactly, and there's not a one big cure. There's not a big cure out there, but
no.
there's several things that you can try. And again, talking with somebody can help you go through and find the best technique or treatment that's going to be the best for you.
And what we were talking about earlier too, is mm-hmm. that, you know, it is very subjective.
Yes.
Because you can have a couple or a man that he is ejaculating in less than a minute, but if both the partners are satisfied, it's not a problem.
Right. If somebody is lasting a minute before they are able to ejaculate
mm-hmm.
and their partner is completely satisfied and he's okay with that, they're not going to be coming in to see anybody because no one's really distressed. It's not causing any problems. Everything's good. They may be finding other ways besides intercourse to actually have an orgasm.
Sure. Sure.
There are other things that can be used. So, again,
it's very subjective.
It is subjective. That's for sure. And let's be clear, because we actually have people coming in thinking, gosh, you know, I last 5 to 10 minutes before I have an ejaculation. I must have PE. No, you don't. If you can last 5-10 minutes, that's very good.
Yeah, because the average is anywhere from three to eight minutes.
That's an average. 3 to 8 minutes. And so if you're in that range, you're doing very, very well.
I think the ones, too, that are the 5 to 10 minutes and I'm a premature ejaculator, they've been watching too many
porn movies.
Porn
yeah.
videos.
Where they don't see the cuts.
Like 20
break.
Minutes later, and they're still there. It's like, okay.
No. Yeah, no. And that's not realistic. And they have to remember that it's a movie, just like watching Lord of the Rings. It's not real, people. It's porn. It's
right.
not real. It's not. That's like thinking Lord of the Rings or Star Wars is real. It's not. It's not real. Sorry, guys. Sorry, Cedric and Rut. It's not real. Anyway, so, and the dilemma sometimes is the man is so wanting to last longer in order to please his partner.
His partner, sure.
Well, if he's with a woman, there is a difference. Women have what we call a longer fuse, meaning it takes longer. If a man takes anywhere from 3 to 8 minutes during intercourse to have an orgasm, right, and ejaculate, it can take women up to 15 to 20 minutes to get aroused, mm-hmm, before. So you can see here where the mismatch is.
Again, another mismatch.
Another mismatch. So that's why we say, one of our colleagues, we have the book in here, one of our colleagues who went to our school, his name is Dr. Ian Kerner. He's up in New York. He's been on the Today Show many times. But he wrote a book. It's called She Comes First. And guys, I can say that on the radio because it's C-O-M-E-S. That's She right. Comes First. And it's because of the rule. In other words, have her prolong your pleasure. Have her have an orgasm first. And then it won't matter how long it takes after that.
That's right.
Instead of worrying about having simultaneous orgasms.
Right.
You have serial ones.
Take the focus off of it. Yeah.
Yeah.
She goes and then you go.
Go and then, there you go. Everybody's happy. So this book is fantastic. She Comes First by Ann Kerner. It's a great book for men. And then he also wrote one for women. It's He Comes Next. Right. Again, based on that rule.
Showing the serial of it.
That there's ways to please women through the clitoris, mm-hmm, much more than through intercourse.
Exactly.
Yes. So there you go. So there's some of the things. So, you know, when you go and see your doctor or you see your therapist, you're going to have to fill out a sexual history. They're going to want to know things like, how often do you have premature ejaculation? Has the problem developed gradually, or is it a new phenomenon? Did it just happen?
Sure.
Have you had it with many several partners or just one specifically? They're going to want to look at.
It could have not happened with other partners, but this specific one, they're not feeling satisfied or...
Right.
You know.
Or how often are you having sex? If it's been a long time,
sure,
you're going to be able to ejaculate and have an orgasm much quicker.
That's true, because the sensation isn't there.
Exactly. They're going to just want to ask you lots of those questions and kind of go through and rule out, like I said, any medical or any kind of psychological. And if they feel that there's no medical, they'll refer you to a sex therapist or a sexologist to help you with the techniques we're going to be talking about next, because there are some that you want to try out first.
Which is?
Yes. The first one they always suggest that you do, once you come see a sex therapist, the first one, we like this one because it doesn't cost any money.
There's no side effects.
There's no side effects like some of the medications we're going to be talking about. And like I said, you might as well try it. It's called the squeeze technique. And for those of you that are listening in your car, there is a video that we often recommend to our clients that are coming in for premature ejaculation.
That's right.
We love it. It's called You Can Last Longer. Okay. That's the name of the video. It's, you can get it at bettersex.com.
That's right.
Bettersex.com. And bettersex.com is made by the Sinclair Intimacy Institute. And they actually go through two techniques, behavioral techniques, to learn to get more control, ejaculatory control.
And one of them being the squeeze technique.
Exactly. And basically what you're doing there is you're actually, where you can do this with masturbation or you have your partner do this, but you're squeezing with your thumb and your
forefinger,
you're squeezing the right below or right...
just below the head of the penis.
Exactly. Right there with the urethra, you're squeezing. And what that's meant to do is force the blood to go back and stop the ejaculation.
Right, right.
And it's just before.
Well, and the other great thing about this technique is you can also do it with your partner.
Yes.
You don't have to do it just alone, or, you know, you can involve your partner in it and make it
fun
about the relationship. It can be part of, you know,
hey, you know what, let's try this. We're going to see how turned on I can get you, you know, that type of thing. And so, you know, the minute you get to what's called the moment of inevitability, which men have, it's that sensation just before they're having an orgasm. That's mm-hmm. when you squeeze, and you're not having to squeeze hard, guys. You squeeze and you slow down and you stop and you go back to other activities like kissing and hugging and no stimulation
right.
of the penis. And then you're able to kind of calm things down and you start again after 30 to 60 seconds
mm-hmm.
and you do it again and you're learning control that way.
Right.
And the video, like I said, covers that. It also covers one, it's called the stop-start method, where you're performing intercourse, you start.
Right.
And when you're almost there, you stop.
Stop. But see, I agree. I mean, there's controversy out there about
if that one
really works or not. And I would agree on that one that, it's...
That'd be very difficult.
A little bit more difficult with that one because you don't have something to stop it,
Exactly.
And if that inevitability comes on, it can come on, in milliseconds.
It's very sneaky.
Yeah.
Very sneaky ejaculation. Whereas women will say things because we're different, they'll right. say things like, just slow down. That's very difficult for a man to do when they're reaching that point of inevitability. Women, we can stop just before orgasm, during or orgasm. We can slow down. Mm-hmm. Any of that stuff can be interrupted. It's very hard for a guy to do that. So
yes, it is.
Yes. So that's one of the things. They also now have medications. You can talk to your doctor. That's why we recommend going to see your urologist, because you can actually get put on medications that help with this, mm-hmm. like an antidepressant medication, like an SSRI.
That's right. That's
Paxil
right.
or some of the other ones. And the reason why they prescribe that is because of the side effect. One of the side effects to these medication is...
delayed ejaculation.
Yeah, you don't get as aroused. It kind of slows things down a little bit. So makes it a little bit harder to reach orgasm. Let's put it that way. So they put you on this medication. You don't have to take it forever, but at least it's something that you can do that helps immediately. Mm-hmm. Whereas then you can learn these other techniques with your partner and,
right. and they also
learn to control that.
They also have the some of the creams out there as well.
That are numb.
They're more like a numbing cream.
Right.
There's controversy on those too.
Some say it works.
Some say it works.
Some say it's too numb. You don't even feel anything.
Right,
they're
right.
not able to maintain an erection.
But I believe that all of these
are things
you can use to help aid in as you're learning these techniques as well.
Exactly.
The behavioral techniques. So.
Exactly. So again, talk to your doctor, talk to a sex therapist because they can help. And also talking to a therapist. We always suggest if you're in a relationship and you're having this problem and you're concerned about it, go together. We always, whenever
That's
there's,
true.
If any partner is having a sexual problem whatsoever and you're in a relationship, we suggest that you both go see a sexologist, sex therapist together. You're both getting the information. Oftentimes we want both people in there because treatment involves the two of you. We might give you exercises for both of you to do.
I even say that if you're going to the doctor, because a lot of times when you go to the doctor and, for instance, you have the problem, men, mm-hmm. for instance, in this situation, you're kind of a little bit anxious about it in general.
Absolutely.
You don't necessarily want to be going telling your doctor, I've got premature death.
Or especially when you call the office. Hi.
Call the office and then they're, what are you coming in for? It's like,
I'm having, I orgasm too quickly. Exactly.
So why I suggest that you should have your partner there with you anyway is because they may hear something that you don't. You're so kind of caught up in the moment and so
nervous
about it that they may hear a lot more things that you don't. And then you guys can talk about it after and communicate and, get it worked out that way. And in general, that's what we always say. What's the biggest thing that helps this?
Attachment.
And communication.
The bond, attachment, safety, security in a relationship so that you can talk to each other openly about these things. It doesn't have to be the problem that it is.
Right, because there's that other part, I don't know if you said it earlier, about the man saying he's sorry so much.
Oh, yeah, please, if you do have it. Yeah, we get that often from women partners, the mm-hmm. ladies. They'll say, gosh, all I hear all the time is, I'm so sorry. And that can become frustrating to hear all the time.
And affect the relationship.
Exactly. You don't have to apologize. This is something that both of you can learn to work with together. And you know what? Again, I think this relates to, again, like you were saying with porn,
right.
this expectation that you just have to last longer. You got to last longer. For what? Oftentimes, the goal is, we got to have an orgasm together. Well, who says? There's other
That's
ways.
True.
There's toys that you can please your partner with. There's vibrators and dildos and all kinds of things.
Yeah.
And it doesn't have to be the main focus.
And like we said, it's, Okay, I just lost
Did you have a premature?
just premature. Had a premature thought coming in and out.
That's all right. It's probably the donuts and the wine. Who knows?
It's the sugar high.
Exactly. Exactly. So, again, if you have any questions, please give us a call on this. 866-826-1340. Again, 866-826-1340. Again, the video, it's called You Can Last Longer.
Yep.
BetterSex.com. It goes over several techniques there. And also the book, She Comes First, by Dr. Ian Kerner.
All right, and we'll be back right after these commercials.
The Lovebirds will be right back with more intimate chats about love, sex, and relationships after these messages.